So good evening, everybody. So I welcome everybody for this lab session. See, today we are going to see the ninth program in the laboratory, right? So what is this ninth program? Ninth program is about write a Java program to implement all the attributes of the page directive tag, right? See, what is the directive? Right? See, directives are nothing but it is a pre-processing commands to the JSP engine. Right? Now, you know that the end product of a JSP page is the servlet. See, before the JSP page translated to the servlet, see, all the commands will be processed. Right? Now, I'll just show you the demo program of this. Now, I'll take the NetBeans editor to demonstrate this particular program. See, you have the NetBeans editor here. Now, see here, this is a web application. The name of the web application I given has Demo 9, right? You can observe here, right? I have created this web project. Now when I explore this, right? You have one folder called as web pages. Within that web pages, I have created this two JSP file and one index.html, right? So you know how to create a web application, right? And you know how to create a JSP page. See, if you don't know, you please refer to the previous videos once, okay? So in that I clearly demonstrated about how to create a JSP page, right? Now, you just see here, I have an index.html. So in index.html, I have created one form. Right? So in that I have included two text boxes here. The first text box name is val1. Right? So the second text box name is val2. Right? So when I click the submit button, right? So the control will be transferred to this particular JSP page. Right? So I have created this divide.jsp page here. This is a divide.jsp. See here. Here I have created all the attributes of this page directive. Right? All the attributes of page directive. Now you just see here. What is an attribute? Attribute is nothing but, right? The feature of the tag, right? And why we are going to use attributes? To accept some values, right? So to accept some values, we are going to use this attribute. Now here you just see, here I have given all the attributes. See the program, what is this program? The program is nothing but to demonstrate all the attributes of the page directive tag. See, these are all the attributes here, right? See, first one is import, content type, page encoding, session, buffer, auto flush, isThread save, is, expression, language ignored, extents, info, language, error page. So these are all the attributes of the page directives, right? Now you just see here. See, if you want to import any package, see, if you want to import any package, you have to use this attribute, right? What is this attribute? Import, right? So you are going to import this particular package in the current JSP program, right? So this is the current JSP program here. Here I'm using this particular to print the date here, this particular package, new date. So it will print today's date and time. Now here, what is this tag called? This is called as an what type of tag? Expression tag, right? So this is the scriptlet tag. So I have used the Java code inside this. See, whatever the parameters I am accepting through the index.html, so I'll accept this using request.getParameter method, right? So that is val1, val2. The first value you're going to accept and you're going to store it in this str1. The second value that you're going to accept and you're going to store it in str2, right? The type of values that you're going to accept from the client is of type string. Now here you're going to convert to the integer. See here, using this method called integer.parseInt, and you are going to use this particular variable name, str1, str2, right? Now what you're going to do it here? See now, using this expression language, you are going to print the value and the result. Now here you see what you're trying to do it here. See here, you see here, is expression language ignored? See, what is this is expression language ignored? See, if see this is expression language ignored, it is having the two values. One is called true, another is called as false. If it is true, so if these particular two lines will be printing as a static message, right? Just like how HTML print, just like HTML will print a static content, no? So it will be treated just like a static content. If it is false, so this expression will be evaluated. See here, you are going to print this value of A, that is param, using this param.val1, the first value you are going to print. A is equal to 10, B is equal to 5. But you have to see that is EL ignore should be false there. Then only this expression will be evaluated, right? Now here you are trying to print out the result here. A divided by B, 10 divided by 5, you're going to get 2. Here A value 5, B value 2, you're going to get 5, right? Now you understood this particular tags. See now you have another some of the tags here. We have the content type. What is the use of the set content type? To set the type of response, right? That client is going to receive, that you're going to set it here, right? That is text/HTML. Now here you just see next tag, that is a session true, right? So when this you see here, this session attribute will take the two values. One is called as a true, another is called as false. When it is going to, when it will be when you're going to give it as true, so it is going to allow this session object in your current JSP page. So when it is false, it will not allow the session object in the current JSP page. So it will throw a 500 error, right? When it is false. So default, it will be true. So suppose that if you're not giving anything, you think that either true or false, if you're not giving this attribute only, so default, it will be false. See, now you have another two attributes, that is called as a buffer and an auto flush. What is the use of the buffer? To set the size of a buffer, right? The out object you have of type JSP print writer, right? So you can set the size of a buffer, right? So when the size of the buffer is 16 KB, you think that, and right, the maximum size of a buffer is 16 KB. Now you're going to use this two attributes, one called buffer, another called auto flush attributes, in conjunction with each other. See, now what happens if you're giving 16, see, the maximum size here you have set 16 KB. Suppose that in the client side, you're going to generate more data. Suppose that 32 KB. If auto flush attribute is true, first that when the buffer is full, that is 16 KB, it will be flushed to the client. It is going to print the client browser. See, when auto flush attribute is false, when buffer is full, you think that you're going to give 32 KB of data, it will hold only 16 KB. When you're going to set this particular auto flush attribute as false, so it will give buffer overflow, because it can handle only the 16 KB of data, right? When it is true, what happens? So the buffer, first 16 KB of data will be flushed to the client. Another 16 KB, it will be flushed. In this case, you will not get buffer overflow error, right? Now, is thread safe attribute. What is the use of is thread safe attribute? See, is thread safe attribute, if it is true, right? If it is true, what happens? So you're going to accept the multiple request from the client, right? In this case, the multiple threads will be created, right? Now, if it is false, you are going to serialize the request. Serialize the request means what happens? So it will process one request at a time. So first request will be processed. Then after submitting the first request, then the second request. In that, it is going to serialize a request. When it is false, it is going to serialize the request. When it is true, so the multiple threads will be executed at the same time. I mean to say is that the multiple requests will be handled, right? So, and if it is false, it is going to implement single thread model interface, right? It is going to implement single thread model interface. See, I'll just show you this particular. So this is divide.jsp, right? When I right click, when I give view servlet here, you just see here what happens here. See, that is what I said here. In divide.jsp, you have this is thread safe. Now what happens here, right? In the target file, that is a servlet, you are going to extend this, see here, single thread model interface here. Right? Now, you see one more attribute called as an info attribute, right? So what is the use of this info attribute? To set the information to the current JSP. See, some information I have set to the current JSP page. See, here you just see, and one method will be generated here in the servlet. So this is a method, it will be generated. See here, that is public string servlet get servlet info. So in the JSP page, you can access this information by using this method. See, where did I use this particular method? You just check it here. I have used it here to display the information. If you want to display this information. So just you can use this. If you want to access this information, you can use that, right? Wherever that you want. That particular method name. For example, you just see here, I want to print here, right? Right? In H1 tag, I want to print this information. I'll just use this. See here. Where is this? It is here. View servlet. See, suppose that if you're going to give, just you copy this method. Copy it. And here you paste it. Right? I think you have to use it in the scriptlet tag. See here I'm trying to print here out dot println, right? Println. I'm going to use it here. See, I can print the name of the program here, right? So this is the use of this info attribute. Now the language element, the language, right? What is this language? The language that so the current JSP, the default language is Java, right? And see here, we have one more attribute called as an error page. So if this particular JSP page, if it is going to generate an error, right? What happens here if it is going to generate an error? Here, when it is going to generate a runtime exception, when you try to divide number by zero, then this exception will be generated, right? Right? Then what happens? This attribute that you're going to see, that if the current JSP page, some error that you're going to occur, right? If the error will be transferred to this particular error JSP, error page dot JSP, see here. So here in this page, I have to use this is error page. Suppose this here in divide dot JSP, if you are using this error page, so here, error, you have to create a separate error page dot JSP. See here, this is error page dot JSP. So when error occurs, then it will be redirected to this page. So, and it will print the cause of an error. When it is going to print the cause of error, see, when is error page, it will be true. Then it will print the cause of an exception. Otherwise, it will not print, right? So there only that exception will be handled in that particular page where you are defined, where here in divide.jsp, right? And extends, you know, when you're going to use a extends, right? So when you're inheriting a page, see here, you are using this org apache jasper runtime jsp http jsp page here. Now here you just see when the generated servlet page, here you see, it has to extend this. See here, this particular class divide.jsp has to extend this org apache jsp jasper runtime jsp base. So this particular extend attributes, it is rarely used, right? So just to demonstrate the extends, that I used this attribute here, right? So this is about this particular program. Just I'll run this program and I'll show you. See, run. When I run this particular page, see, this is index.html page. Now if I am going to give 10, 1 minute. See, this is the page when I run this particular program, right? So when I'm going to give 2, what is an output value that you're going to get here? The output value that you're going to get, see here. See, the result you're going to get 5. 10 divided by 2, it is 5, right? This is an, now here you see, what is this? This is an information. See, you remember this, that info attribute, right? So that info attribute, what is the use of it? To set the information about the page. Later I retrieved using get servlet info. So this is particular message here, demonstrate all the attributes of page directive, right? Now, this is what the package which I import java.util.star to print the today's date, current date and time. Now, the expression language, right, I have used. The expression language there I have used it as false, so that it is printing the values here A and B. Otherwise it would have printed a string message, right? Now here you just see, again I'll run this particular program here. See what happens here. Now this is index.html. Now I'll show you that exception here, 10 divided by 2. When I click this button, you just see this, welcome, 5 you're going to get. right? See here I am going to give 110. Now I am going to give it as 0. Here the current JSP page will generate an exception, and the expression will be redirected to error.jsp page, and that error.jsp page will print the cause of an exception. See here, when I click the calculate, you just see here it is going to print the cause of an exception here. Arithmetic, that is java.lang.arithmeticexception/0. Okay, so this is about this lab program 9.